check this. I will write some text and just listen to the quality of the voice this Murph AI engine generates.
If you can finish your target in the gym, turn the workspace into a fitness zone. Every step counts, whether in the gym or in front of the computer. Embrace the journey and adapt.
Okay, quick flash forward. Now let's head back to our Python editor. I will write my favorite Sherlock Holmes quote and listen to this.
It is a capital mistake to theorize before one has data. Insensibly, one begins to twist facts to suit theories instead of theories to suit facts.
Our little Python code literally cloned that exact same previous voice within a few seconds. As my grandma often says, the best things in the life are open sourced. So, from the flash forward, let's get back to the present and let me show you a step-by-step guide to achieve this. And along with that, I hope you will realize the importance of virtual environment in Python. Sticking to our top-down learning philosophy, we will learn Python with some fun projects. Hello, welcome to Quantext. My name is Alex. So what on earth is a virtual environment? And why should I complicate life if I can get by using a single Python installation? Well, it's not that complicated. You have to remember this one line only, or write it down somewhere. Conda create, and for the name of choice, Python is equal to the version of choice of Python, Anaconda. That's it. Assuming you install Python using Anaconda like a responsible adult. If you are serious about algo trading and artificial intelligence, we covered that already in previous videos, right? So first, it's not that complicated. A virtual environment is just an isolated Python environment within your existing Python setup. The biggest plus is you can easily manage different versions of Python and packages without going through the complications of setting the path in the Windows environment variables. And trust me, at some point you will need it. Soon in this video, I am going to explain it to you with a practical example and why I needed it. So, okay, enough of convincing. Let's get back to our fun project. If you are on Instagram or TikTok, you must have heard these AI-generated text-to-speech voices with some inspirational quote along with some upbeat background music. There are a lot of online services out there like Murph AI, Wellsaid Labs, to name a few, but free and paid subscription plans. Basically, I wanted to clone this.
If you can finish your target in the gym, turn the workspace into a fitness zone. Every step counts, whether in the gym or in front of the computer. Embrace the journey and adapt.
I was quite impressed with the quality of the sound, but I accidentally found the easiest way to get that kind of TTS quality on our local machine. Thanks to my habit of checking Hugging Face models, if there is any new interesting AI model to play with, or what is trending in the AI world if I don't have any time. As you can see, there are so many models out there on various topics on Hugging Face. Now, here comes the Coqui X-TTS version 2. It is the top trending text-to-speech AI model on Hugging Face. It clones any given voice of only 6 seconds without any training at all and generates our written text to that given voice. All you need is just one clip of 6 seconds. You can literally download any voice you want from the internet of your favorite celebrity or audiobook narrator. It's better if it does not have any background noise or music. So I downloaded that clip from Murph AI and decided to clone that voice. So for that part, first we have to install Coqui X-TTS using the pip install TTS command. But here is the issue. I have Python version 3.11 in my Conda environment, as we covered that in Conda installation basics video. But the problem is PyTorch, which is a backbone for a lot of AI models along with this Coqui X-TTS, is not yet supported for Python 3.11 on Windows. It's supported on Linux, but not on Windows. So here comes our virtual environment. We will create a new virtual environment using Anaconda with this line that I told you before. So we will write that line here using command prompt. I named that virtual environment TTS, and we will install Python 3.10 with this command. After that, we activate the new virtual environment by simply writing activate and the name of our virtual environment, which in this case is TTS. So activate TTS while staying in this virtual environment. Now we will install PyTorch first and then Coqui X-TTS. It will take some time since these are big libraries. I will fast forward this process. Now after installation, to check whether it works or not, we import PyTorch. Okay, it didn't give us any error. Cool. Now we will check whether CUDA is installed or not, because sometimes PyTorch uses CPU, even though you have NVIDIA GPU in your machine. We write this line. Here it says true. It means PyTorch recognizes we have CUDA enabled machine. In simple words, PyTorch will use our GPU instead of the CPU for inference. Side note, for those who are new to all of this, in deep learning or AI, training and inference are two different parts. Training a big model requires massive GPUs. So nowadays, they come up with pre-trained models on a massive amount of data using attention algorithms and encoders, decoders. I won't go deep into that. The only thing you want to know is we can fine-tune these models using our custom data on Google's Colab for a few hours or sometimes days for models like automatic speech recognition or ASR. OpenAI's Whisper model is the best in that regard. I will cover that topic in some other video, since I went through all of that procedure described above. The reason I'm saying all of that is to use this Coqui X-TTS model, or in proper technical term, for inference, we don't have to train this TTS model. Like I said, just give 6 seconds audio clip and it will generate the exact same voice. It will literally clone that voice. This is astonishing stuff, seriously. Those who spent hours of time fine tuning their model will understand what I'm talking about. Okay, so now we will go back to our Python editor and import the TTS model. But before that, we have to set our PyCharm for our new virtual environment. The best thing is PyCharm already has the Conda setup, and by clicking a few tabs, we can set up our new project. I will just show you how.
First, click on Conda environment tab, and then to select Conda executable path, it is located in this library folder. Basically, you are looking for this conda.bat file. Click OK and then click on load environments, and then use existing environment. By drop down button, we can select our existing environment TTS. Click OK and it will load our virtual environment.
We will copy paste this line from Coqui X-TTS readme page into our editor. It's time for magic. We are interested in this part. We will write our desired text here, and the file path of the voice we want to clone will be here. The first time when you run this line, it will ask you whether you are using it for commercial purpose or for personal use. If you are using it for personal use, type Y. So assuming you are using it for personal purpose, type Y, press enter. I have already done that, so it wouldn't ask me this time. Now we will select the exact line within Merp AI and execute it. Wait for a few seconds for magic to unfold, and it will generate the audio file, and our task is complete. You can see how much time it took. Let's play this file.
If you can't finish your target in the gym, turn the workspace into a fitness zone. Every step counts, whether in the gym or in front of the computer.
You can see there is almost no difference, except additional pauses we asked in Merp AI. We can easily add pauses here too by adding commas and full stops in the text. Now let's write another text and see the result. Yeah, this is my favorite Sherlock Holmes line. Okay, so let's see how it sounds.
It is a capital mistake to theorize before one has data. Insensibly, one begins to twist facts to suit theories instead of theories to suit facts.
Oh, it worked flawlessly. And this time, inference time is far lower because it already loaded the model on GPU. So it doesn't have to do it again. If you're using CPU, don't worry. It will take a little extra time, but I think it will work on CPU as well. I haven't tested though. Let me know in the comments. And by the way, I used one of these voice clips for my Instagram reel here. Shameless plug.
The only thing standing between you and your goal is the bullshit story you keep telling yourself as to why you can't achieve it.
Okay, and there are endless possibilities to use it. I just wanted to show you one of the possibilities. You can make your own audio file, etc. And that's it for now. Thanks for watching the video. If you find it useful, then boost the YouTube algorithm. Until then, see you. Bye.